Hello and welcome to Dental Studies Simplified. I am Dr. Ankita Kotecha and in today's video we will discuss pocket. Okay, this is another very frequently asked query about pocket, especially the terminologies about pockets. Like for example, difference between intra-bony pocket and infra-bony pocket. What are the alternative names for supra-bony pocket? What is the difference between supra-bony and intra-bony pocket? So let us discuss periodontal pocket in detail. So as already discussed, periodontal pocket is a pathology. So pathological deepening of the sulcus. How? By apical migration of the base of the sulcus due to the destruction of the periodontal structures. Okay, the destruction of periodontium. Why such definition? Because let's see here. This is the sulcus. Okay, this is a healthy sulcus. Now, this sulcus depth can deepen in two ways. Either by the coronal migration of the free gingival margin or the apical migration of the base of the sulcus. There are two ways in which this sulcus can deepen. So, the deepening by apical migration of the base of the sulcus due to the destruction of the periodontal tissues is called periodontal pocket. Of course, the deepening associated with coronal migration of the free gingival margin is also considered, but periodontal pocket is the one which is associated with the deepening, pathological deepening of the sulcus by apical migration of the base of the sulcus. Clear? We will discuss the classification wherein this concept will be clarified. This definition will be justified. So now let us discuss the classification of pocket. In this diagram, as you can appreciate, the base of the sulcus is at or coronal to CEJ. That means this is a healthy sulcus. Coming to this diagram, if you can appreciate, the base of the sulcus is still at CEJ or coronal to CEJ. But still there is deepening of the sulcus. How? Due to coronal migration of the free gingival margin. This point, free gingival margin, as you can appreciate, the free gingival margin has migrated coronally. So this deepening of the sulcus, this pocket is due to coronal migration of the free gingival margin, and that is why this is called pseudo pocket or gingival pocket. Okay, so the query difference between pseudo and gingival pocket is now resolved. Okay, this type of pocket which is associated with coronal migration of the free gingival margin is called gingival pocket or pseudo pocket. Why pseudo? Because it is not true to the definition of pocket. The definition of pocket is apical migration of the base of the sulcus, destruction of the periodontal tissue. Clear? And that is why this type of pocket is called pseudo pocket or gingival pocket. So now coming to, if this is pseudo pocket, what is a true pocket? So true pocket, or also known as periodontal pocket, is the one which has the deepening of the sulcus due to apical migration of the base of the sulcus associated with the destruction of the underlying structures. Which all the structures? Cementum, periodontal tissues and bone. So now under true or periodontal pocket we have two types, supra-bony and intra-bony. Again, lots of confusion. See, under true or periodontal, both of them are true or periodontal pocket because both have deepening of the sulcus associated with apical migration of the base of the sulcus. Now, under true or periodontal pocket, we have supra-bony and infra-bony. First, I will clarify the various terminologies. Supra-bony, also known as supra-alveolar, supra-crestal. Clear? Supra-bony, supra-alveolar, supra-crestal. So that means this base of the sulcus is above, supra, superior to the crest of the alveolar bone. If you can compare the levels of the base of the sulcus and the crest of the alveolar bone. Base of the sulcus is above, superior or supra to the crest of the alveolar bone. That is why it is called supra bony, superior to the bone. Supra bony, supra alveolar, because alveolar bone, and supra crestal, because crest of the alveolar bone. Clear? Coming to the next type, infra bony. Here the base of the sulcus is below, inferior, infra, in the position to the crest of the alveolar bone. See, the base of the sulcus is below. Here the base of the sulcus is above. Here it is below. That is why infra bony, also known as intra bony. This is the most frequently asked query. Difference between intra bony and infra bony, it's one and the same. Infra, inferior. Intra, because it is inside. Intra, it's between the tooth root and the bone. This base of the sulcus is in between the tooth root and the bone. That is why intra. Infra, because below the crest of the alveolar bone. Infra bony, intra bony, and even subcrest. Okay, it's also known as subcrestal. Supracrestal, subcrestal. Okay, so these are the various terminologies and alternative names. Clear till now? Okay, so now with this, we will proceed to the next classification, which is based on the number of surfaces involved. If, let's say, on a tooth we have 6 sides, okay, or 4 surfaces, mesial, distal, buccal and lingual or palatal, okay, 4 surfaces and 6 points. So if only one surface on one tooth is involved, simple pocket. If more than one surface, let's say 2, then compound. And if it is like originating on one surface and progressing towards another surface, that is how it is involving the two surfaces, then it is a complex pocket. It is also known as spiral pocket. It's very common in the furcation areas. It begins in the furcation and progresses further. Okay, so this is another classification: simple, compound and complex. Complex, also known as spiral, very common in furcation areas. So the classification is clear till now. Now we will discuss two things. One is the clinical features of pocket and correlate it with the histopathology. Second, the difference between suprabony and infrabony pockets. Okay, we'll discuss both of them one by one. So, talking about the clinical features, let's say here, clinical features and histopathology. Clinical features we have, first is the color, bluish red. Okay, bluish red discoloration is due to circulatory stagnation. Then we have flaccidity of the tissues because of the destruction of the fibers. We have smooth, shiny surface because of the edema and inflammation. Then we have pitting, again because of the edematous tissue. Okay, and then the next point is less frequently, but it is pink and firm. This is when the fibrotic tissue changes are predominant or are more than edematous. See, there are two types of changes ongoing, fibrotic and edematous. If the fibrotic overrides edematous, then the tissue becomes pink and firm. But this is again disguising. Okay, so why? Because it looks pink and firm, which is very normal, but the underlying tissues are highly inflamed and ulcerated. So from there we have another point, pain. Pain because of the ulceration. We have bleeding, same, ulceration, and increased vascularity. then sometimes we have pus. That is because of the suppurative changes. So clear, we have correlated the clinical features of a pocket with the underlying histopathology. Bluish red discoloration is attributed to the circulatory stagnation, flaccidity of the tissues to the destruction of gingival fibers, smooth shiny surface to the edema and destruction, pitting on pressure is due to edema, pink and firm tissues less frequently due to fibrotic changes which are more than edematous, pain is due to ulceration, bleeding is due to ulceration and increased vascularity, pus is due to suppurative changes. Clear? Now we will proceed to the next question, difference between supra-bony and intra-bony pocket. Supra-bony, infra-bony. Again, the alternative names, supra-alveolar, supra-crestal, infra-bony, intra-bony, subcrestal. Now here, the base is above the bone, okay? Base of sulcus. And here, it's below. And that is why, when we probe supra-bony pockets, see, this is the supra-bony pocket. The base is above the crest. So when you probe this pocket, the lateral wall will be soft because it is only soft tissue. So the lateral probing will not give you any resistance. It will be soft wall. Whereas here in infra-bony, okay, the base is here and the crest is here. When you probe this pocket, infra-bony, and you probe it laterally, you will get a hard resistance because of this bone. So, the lateral probing of infra-bony pocket will be hard because of the bony wall. Okay? Hard resistance because of the hard bony wall. Okay? So, these are the main differences. And then the third difference is, supra-bony pockets usually have horizontal bone loss pattern. Okay? And infra-bony pockets have vertical, again this is one another query, vertical and angular. Difference between vertical and angular bone loss, they are the same, vertical, because angular because they have some angle of bone loss. Okay, here it is flat and here it has some angle. Okay, and that is why that bone loss, okay, you can appreciate the bone loss here and the horizontal bone loss. These are the main differences clinically between supra-bony pockets and infra-bony pockets. Now there is the next query regarding periodontal pocket is the site specificity. Again, this has to be a confusion because site specificity is associated in multiple places. Okay, there is elsewhere also where we have site specificity. So, but here in periodontal pocket, the site specificity is denoting that periodontal pocket formation does not begin on all the teeth and all the surface of the same tooth at the same time. See, it begins on one tooth or maybe on the one surface of a tooth at a time. Okay, so that is the high variation and that is what is called site specificity. Specific site on a tooth or a specific tooth is affected at a time and it's not going to happen generalized. Pocket formation doesn't begin generalized on all the teeth at the same time. There is some site specificity owing to certain local factors which are favorable to the periodontal pathogenesis. That is called site specificity. See, site specificity is very confused or mostly confused with microbial specificity also. In the chapter microbial specificity, the microbial complexes or microbial composition of various periodontal diseases, there we have microbial specificity. So please don't confuse site specificity with that microbial specificity. Okay, this is one major confusion just because of the term specificity. Now the last query for today's video, healing lesions, periodontal pocket as healing lesions. Okay, this is one very interesting question. Why are periodontal pockets called healing lesions? because at a time whenever this pocket is examined, there are two processes ongoing. One is the destructive and the other one is repair. That means periodontal pockets are always undergoing or trying to undergo repair, but they never attain 100% repair. Why? Because of the destructive changes or destructive mechanisms ongoing as well. Both the mechanisms are ongoing simultaneously. When they are already or they are constantly under the bacterial or microbial attack, the destructive or the inflammatory changes are always taking place because they are constantly under microbial attack. But at the same time, they are trying to repair themselves also. But because of this ongoing destructive changes, 100% repair is never achieved. And that is why periodontal pockets are considered to be healing lesions and not healed. Why not healed? Because 100% repair is not achievable. There is always healing taking place. They are trying to undergo healing. They are trying to undergo repair, but again they are under constant attack of the microbes. That is why they are not able to attain 100% repair. In this destructive changes, mainly there are fibrotic changes and edematous changes. It depends on the inflammation. Okay. So, if the fibrotic is overriding edematous, the tissues will be pink and firm. If it is edematous which is overriding the fibrotic one, the tissues will be reddish, bluish red or reddish and soft and pitting on pressure. Okay. Whereas fibrotic tissues will be pink, firm. Okay. So, this is the answer why periodontal pockets are called healing lesions and not healed lesions. So, this completes the topic for today. We have discussed periodontal pockets classification, gingival or pseudo pocket, periodontal or true pocket and combined pocket. Combined pocket means in which there is both coronal migration of the gingiva as well as apical migration of the base of the sulcus. Let me draw it here for you. This is a combined pocket. See, this is the CEJ, this is the base of the sulcus which is migrated apically, and this free gingival margin which should be somewhere here. Let me draw ideal one. So, this free gingival margin should have been somewhere here, but it migrated coronally. So, this portion of the pocket depth is contributed by coronal migration of the free gingival margin, and this portion of the pocket is contributed by apical migration of the base of the sulcus. So, a pocket in which both the things are evident, coronal migration of the free gingival margin and apical migration of the base of the sulcus, is called combined pocket. Okay. So, the examples for combined pocket is usually inflammatory enlargement. Okay. So, any enlargement case with associated with periodontal disease will fall under combined pockets case. Okay. Because there will be a combination of both. The enlargement will contribute to the coronal migration of free gingival margin, and the underlying periodontal disease will contribute to the pathological deepening of the sulcus due to apical migration of the base of the sulcus. Okay. Whereas the pseudo pockets, that is only the coronal migration of free gingival margin is evident. The example for pseudo pockets is enlargement in absence of any periodontal disease. Okay, only true enlargement. Okay, true enlargements are associated with pseudo pockets. Okay, please be careful with the terminologies. Please try to understand it. And true and periodontal pockets are the clinical, most important clinical feature of any periodontal disease, especially the ones which are treated by flap therapy. Okay. So, these are the various examples: true periodontal pockets, pseudo gingival pockets and combined pockets. And then we have under true or periodontal pocket, supraboni and infraboni. The alternative name: supraboni, supracrestal, supraalveolar. For the infraboni, it's intraboni and subcrestal. And then we have simple pocket, compound pocket and complex pocket, also known as spiral, common in the furcation area. Then we discussed the correlation of clinical features of the pocket with its histopathology. Then we discussed the difference between suprabony pocket and infrabony pocket. Then we discussed site specificity and finally periodontal pocket as a healing lesion. So I hope all the queries regarding a periodontal pocket are cleared now. But if there are any more queries about this topic or any other topic, do let me know in the comment section below or mail it to my email ID dentalstudiesimplified@gmail.com. Alternatively, you can reach me on Instagram DM and Facebook Messenger. Thank you for watching and listening to me. Study well. Have a good day. Stay safe.